That's not something you can plan. It's just because we go to each other's breweries, we drink each other's beer, and we know what's damn good. So let's continue that tradition tonight as we go through each of the awards. It was a fantastic day for everybody that wasn't here for the full day, but if you were here for the conference, it was awesome. Julie's marketing tips and advice, Audra's financial success stories were great, Brian Roth's kind of in the weeds data on beer, my jokes about Papazian were wonderful. Thank you. You were the only one that clapped. Speaking of, this is another reason this event is so fantastic. Spinning the tunes, that's right. He gives me a discount on his DJ service. John Gross, everybody, will be taking you through each and every award. Are the songs timed up with the categories?
Not at all.
Not at all. However, you think they will be, sort of, which is great. I want to say a thank you and a shout out to our competition sponsors. It would not have been possible without the support of all the sponsors. TBI, Pro Brew Supply, BSG, yeah, you can do for each one. BSG, Malt Europe, TNB Boiler, yeah! And OPA Design Studio. Thank you for supporting the Texas Craft Brewers Cup. A little overview for the night tonight. We're gonna do the Ambassador of Craft Award, the Texas Craft Brewers Cup medals, and the Brewery of the Year award winners. Now before we get started, we started the day this morning. Everybody, I need you to listen for just one second because I'm gonna have you do something. We started the day on kind of an interactive note with taking a little trivia quiz with everybody. And then we also started out with talking about what's working and what's right with breweries. So I need everybody to do something for me, and we're literally going to do this for 1 minute. I have a clock here, so I want you to stand up. Find somebody you do not know, which I know is kind of tough because you're in brewery groups. Find somebody you do not know and tell them, other than beer, your favorite thing about going to a brewery. Why you love going to a brewery. So stand up, tell them your name, and why you love visiting a brewery in Texas.
Together.
so my point in doing this is, as we know, we started the day with a panel about what's working in beer, right? What's working in beer, because we're always hearing what's not working in beer. And my point in doing this is, between all of us, we have thousands of answers of what is working in beer. And going to breweries, people want to be there. They want to be there with you. They want to be there with your cool mechanical equipment and see how you tinker on electronics or engineering. They want to be there and play Uno with their kids at the table and nobody has their phone. And those are the things that are working in beer. So just remember that when you're down or you had a bad month of sales, of why people are coming to your tap room. Don't ever forget that stuff. With that being said, we're going to talk about another thing that is working in beer, and those are the sometimes unsung heroes of our industry that have worked tirelessly to promote all of us. It's an award we came up with a few years ago called Partners in Craft. Oh, no, sorry. No, it's not.
Turn up the mic.
Oh. He's working on it. You can't hear me? Man, John, I was so good. I was so good, nobody could hear me. All right, I think we're good. It is called Ambassador of Craft Award. Thank you, Rick. Yeah. And it is those unsung heroes, people that have supported our industry. Some work in the industry, sometimes they don't work in the industry. We always take nominations for that. And past winners are Charles Valenrot, Brock Wagner, Marvis Dixon, Jason Davis, and Rebecca Garcia. And to present the first award, we will have the one and only John Lamb from Redhorn Brewing come and present the first award.
Thank you, Winnie. What's up, Texas? So I'm honored to be doing this on quite literally my last day of service with the board of directors. A little bit bittersweet. I have two responsibilities today and then I'm officially retired. But I couldn't be happier to present this award after 6 years of being on the board to someone that I've spent a lot of time with, both personally and professionally. Frankly, their work doesn't even have to be spoken at this point. But I'll share a few words from Charles Valenrat, who nominated him, because I feel like that's important. Do I really need to write anything about this person? Not going to say yet. His creativity, his drive, his vision brought about one of the biggest legislative wins for craft beer in Texas and gained the attention of the entire industry nationwide. Beer to Go and the lesser-known changes to TABC code driven by the Sunset Committee bill in the 2019 legislative session would not have happened without this person. Those changes proved to be absolutely critical less than a year when COVID struck. Beyond his driven legislative work, he has always been one of the Guild's greatest champions and resources for Guild staff and new breweries alike. His visions for the industry and his own brewery are driven by ambition, integrity, and care, and I'll add quality. The Guild was lucky to have him on the board for 8 years. This person puts the industry above all else and has proven from all of us here, a mentor of mine in the industry, a man I have now called friend for many years, and a man who I have just shared many pints with when I should have been here listening to panels. I present to you the Ambassador of Craft Award. Please give a huge shout out, Adam DeBauer. Yeah.
Thank you.
one or two things to say, but honestly, my God, this is such an incredible honor. I stand here tonight where so many of my mentors and good friends have stood before me, grateful and proud. I'm grateful for the recognition of my part, but I'm also so incredibly proud of what we, over so many years, accomplished together. It was never my work, but it was always our work. Woo! After all, we're Texas craft brewers, and what we do matters. Sorry, I'm stoked. When I started my brewing career now 17 years ago, I couldn't imagine where I'd get to go with beer. The same things that drew me in then still captivate me today. The people on both sides of the bar make all of the difference. And in some ways, it feels like this award could be the kind of thing a brewer receives towards the end of his or her career. But I believe it's the kind of award any and all of us should aspire to attain and then keep moving forward. This is the award that tells us we're on the right track and that we should keep reaching farther. I've said to anyone who listens that the current guild leadership is the most talented and engaged I've ever seen. And I will restate that again loudly and on the record. Caroline, Meg, Travis, and Sheila. In my opinion, these are the best in class staff of any guild that they could ever hope to have working on its industry's issues. But I'm even more impressed with the directors on this board. They rise to meet challenges that we as members never see. And then later we all happily enjoy the fruits of those efforts. And I'd argue nearly all of our individual business models today exist because of the hard work of this guild, its legislative efforts and its past leaders. And though many of us are seeing significant challenges in our own businesses and those of our friends and peers, I know this guild is grinding every day to help us all move past these challenges and into the next era of prosperity for us all. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't take this opportunity to call upon all of you to action. Do you have an opinion about the direction this guild is moving? Run for the board. Do it. Put your name in there. Do you want us to change some laws? Volunteer and get engaged with the Government Affairs Committee. Do you love the idea of sitting through a TABC stakeholder meeting and influencing the utterly thrilling process of rulemaking? This guild needs your help. And the opportunities for guild service are nearly endless, and I promise that every one of you in this room today is capable of accomplishing great things for this community. After all, it is the people of this industry who make it worth working for. I'm humbled and honored to win this award tonight. I can't wait to move forward with all of you guys as this guild continues to blaze its trail. The trail that all other guilds in the U.S. now watch and do their best to follow. Humbled and honored. Thank you guys so much. Cheers. I genuinely am honored to be up here to present this award to someone who, frankly, everyone in this room knows in one way or another. They're a certified Cicerone, honestly the most trusted palate in my home city that I frankly bug them every time they come to my tap room to taste a beer. And that's all great, I could go on and on about her resume, but frankly, that's not the most impressive part. Genuinely, the most impressive part is the way that she builds relationships. Relationships with beer nerds like all of us in here. She can listen to us and talk to us and match us in every way, which is impressive, but even more impressive is her ability to bring in those non-beer nerds and those people that we all hate talking to. And I genuinely envy the patience that she has. She puts that tireless, like, pursuit of education, quality, and excellence, whether it's through Pink Boots, starting the chapter in San Antonio, or our DEI committee here at the Guild, or at a previous position with an education program that was public-facing and brought more consumers. She truly was an ambassador of our craft. Again, I don't want to waste anyone's time because the person who should be up here talking is her. So I want to give you
this award. And please join me in welcoming Paige Martin to the stage.
Single one of our breweries with everything that I do, with talking to people, with, you know, volunteering, helping to organize, all that stuff. And I just really, I'm so thankful and grateful that you guys let me back. That's thank you. And I just want to give one special shout out to my partner, Alex Rendon at Freetail. I didn't know whenever we got together that he was also volunteering for life for every project I have ever taken on. So thank you for that and for all your help with everything. And yeah, also to every single one of my San Antonio breweries. All 24 mighty of you now. I'm so proud of you, and I love every single one of you, and you're doing amazing things, and I want to keep doing amazing things with you and keep growing with you, with all of you guys here in Texas. Thank you. Let's get to the main thing.
Statistics. As you well know, we've had 956 entries this year. Yeah. 170 Texas craft breweries. That's 100 more entries and 13 more breweries than last year. The competition has grown from 27 to 31 medals, which is why we only had a very short intro. So no jokes this year, friends. I'm so sorry. The 93 Bolo medals will be given out today and taken home by you wonderful brewers out there. We had 55 judges and 18 very, very dedicated volunteers doing the cellar work. All right? None of this would have been possible without those guys. Okay, it's time to begin announcing the medals, but I do have something else to say first. As you can tell from last year, we're a little bit opposite of what we were, right? So you're gonna be coming up stage right, my left. You're gonna come, you're gonna pause, take your pictures, and then you're gonna get the hell off stage and then go through this door, all right? But remember this, keep an ear out, because it might just be that you get another award and you have to come back around and get back up on stage. So don't go running out into the hallway until you hear the finish of the category, all right? Alright, let's see. As has become tradition, many of our categories are also the largest. So I'll be announcing categories once again in reverse from category 31 to category 1. Now, we had to split some categories. You'll see which ones as they come up, because they were very large. And I know that you guys are on the edge of your seats. You've been waiting for this all day. You want to hear who won. But before I get started, I want to invite back John Lamb, because he's going to talk about something new in the competition this year. John?
Well, shit, you have me again. Sorry. So let's talk about the Legislative Pro-Am. It was a new category. It feels like good timing now to... This is officially my last responsibility on the board. To officially end my term with this, and also to have just presented an award to someone who is fundamental in what has transpired in the Capitol with Texas Craft Beer. With the works of folks like Adam, others in the room, you know who you are. Our crossover group, our lobbyist group, the crossover group, who frankly, our bill probably barely keeps the lights on for, and amazing staff. We've gone from a group that was barely recognized in the Capitol less than a decade ago to a group, an organization who is widely known by everyone in the Capitol. Going from a group that could barely get a meeting with anyone and being called disruptors in the industry to now having over 15 beers in the category of legislative collaboration with over 16 legislators in and around the state on both sides of the aisle. Mind you, it was 8 Democrats and 8 Republicans, so we definitely were equally split. These were extremely fun projects and a great opportunity for these folks to not only us go visit their office and talk about our businesses, but for them to come in and really get a sneak peek into what we really do day in and day out. I'm excited. We won People's Choice Award with Representative John Busey, not awarded tonight, but really exciting. And it was really a fun project, so I encourage anyone next year to participate if you can. So further, another honor to introduce the Texas Legislative Pro-Am category, and it feels only appropriate knowing the progression of again, being an industry that was not known, to an industry and an organization that is very well known. We put politics aside and we work on one single issue, Texas craft beer. So, with that being said, I want to let you guys hear about the winners for the Texas Pro-Am category.
Thank you, John. Thank you, everybody, for being here. And just before we start, I just want to say that the Texas craft beer scene is wonderful. It's engaged. You've probably heard about a few things that were going on, but just keep putting one foot after the next, doing what's right for your business and making the beer that we know we could make and getting the people in there that we know we can please, and keep on doing what you're doing, because it's a wonderful thing and it's proud. It's Texas proud. It makes me proud. It should make all of you proud. Thank you. All righty. So, this got mixed up a bit. All right, let me go back. I'm not sure how that happened.
The bourbon and the shot.
Ah, that did it. That did it. Okay, let's hope we can get this right back into order. Here we go. There it is. There's another one. Okay, so, category 31, Legislative Pro-Am. 15 entries. The bronze goes to Impeachment from Holdout Brewing and the Office of Representatives, Ramon Romero Jr. Austin. Thank you. to FAYM. Forever, always, your McKinney, Tux Brewery, and the Office of State Representative, Kyle Frazier, and Jeff Leach of McKinney. District 138 Mexican Hot Chocolate Stout, Senate Avenue Brewing Company, and the Office of State Representative, Lacey Hall, Jersey Village. Andrew, Adam Gray. All the breweries that participated in the legislative pro-am, I hope more of you do it next year. We had 15 this year. Let's make it 45 next year, all right? Category 30, pastry, dessert, puree, aka decadent beers. 14 entries. The bronze goes to Jamie Tart. Pondesita. Excuse me, on the setup, Brewing Company, Amarillo, Texas. And the silver goes to Sinister Shadows, False Idol Brewing, North Richard Hills. Goes to Kokomo Royale, Blue Owl Brewing, Austin, Texas. Entries, and the bronze goes to Weller Weiss, or Weller Weiss, depending on where you're from, Two Dots Brewing Company, Lubbock, Texas. The silver medal goes to Social Betty Ann, Edgewise 8 Brewing, Weatherford. And the gold goes to Hefeweizen, Live Oak Brewing Company, Austin, Texas. Experimental hybrid and specialty beers, 18 entries. The bronze goes to Saison in the Abyss, Alamo Beer Company, San Antonio, Texas. Springs, Texas. Brewing, Houston, Texas. Houston, that's been hometown to me for 21 years, 19, 18. I have to ask my wife, she's my memory and my heart. All right, congratulations, guys. Category 27, barrel and wood-aged beer, 40 entries. The bronze goes to Rio Reserve. Brewing Company, Houston, Texas. And the bowl. Left-handed hummingbird. Excitement. 13 entries. Congratulations, y'all. Oh, rule breakers! Rule breakers! That's what craft beer is all about, anyway. Smoking chili beers, 13 entries. The bronze goes to GG's Juice, Maple Branch Craft Brewery, Fort Worth, Texas. The silver, Jalapeno Cesar, On Rotation Brewing in Dallas, Texas. And the gold goes to Smoke Session, Armor Brewing Company, Allen, Texas. and barrel-aged sour and Brett beer. 12 entries, so you know what category to go in next year. Sea of Waves, True Anomaly Brewing Company, Houston, Texas. And the silver goes to Killer Streams Golden Sour, Austin Beer Works. Austin, Texas. To Flanders Redux, True Anomaly Brewing Company, Houston, Texas! Remember what I said, don't go too far! Seven entries. The bronze goes to Rebus Rex, Vector Brewing, Dallas, Texas. Vista Brewing, Driftwood, Texas.
Goes to White Dwarf, True Anomaly Brewing, Houston, Texas.
42. Chocolate and coffee, 40 entries. The bronze goes to Coffee Milk Stout, Front Yard Brewing, Spicewood, Texas. To MFC, Equal Parts Brewing Company, Houston, Texas. All right, exciting, exciting Houston times here. The gold goes to Drip. Great Heights Brewing Company, Houston, Texas!
Company,
Nederland, Texas. Belgian and farmhouse ales, 33 entries. The bronze goes to Squirtle Squad, False Island Brewing, North Richard Hills, Texas. Silver goes to Run, refreshing, unfiltered decoction, Starbase Brewing, Austin. And the gold goes to, and this might sound like a repeat, Let It Rip, Full Silent Brewing Company, North Richard Hills. This is a category that I truly love. Barley wine and strong ale. 23 entries. The bronze goes to Old Impresarios, Fredonia Brewing, Nacogdoches, Texas. Silver goes to Old Man Marley, Good Line Beer Company, Lubbock, Texas. Texas Beer Company, Taylor, Texas. The silver goes to Sunrise, Pondicetta, Brewing Company, Texas. to Karnstein, Acapon Brewing Company, Dripping Springs, Texas. Specialty Hoppy, 22 entries. The bronze goes to Ladywood Spruce Tip, Bear King Brewing, Marble Falls, Texas. Goes to Silent Laughter, Fast Friends Beer Company, Austin, Texas. The gold goes to Let the People Dance, Honda Center Brewing Company, Amber Roll, Texas. Entries. And the bronze goes to Velvet Veil, Lakewood Brewing Company. And the silver goes to Rose Colored Glasses, Odd News Brewing, Farmers Branch, Texas. EVA number 3, Valenson's Brewing Company, Pearland, Texas. All of them are homies. Okay, category 14. And the brewers bowed and prayed to the hazy gods they made. Hazy IPAs, 61 entries. The bronze goes to Juice Pack from Tufts Brewery. And the silver goes to Hazy IPA, Front Yard Brewing, Spicewood, Texas. Lamborghini truck, Bird Creek Brewing Company, Temple, Texas. Categories. It's the American IPA category, and the sponsor is not here to present, but I do have a slight commercial for them. American IPA Category 13, sponsored by T&B Boiler, veteran-owned and operated, and committed to developing and customizing industry-leading boiler room solutions to help customers achieve their financial and operational goals. Go to T&B Boiler. And now for something completely different. Category 13, American IPA. 56 entries. And the bronze goes to Nerf Wars, Bird Creek Brewing Company, Temple, Texas. Told you not to go too far. Goes to Neighborhood Bully, Hound Song Brewing Company, Columbus, Texas. Ethics and Standards IPA, Oddwood Brewing Company, Austin, Texas. goes to Milf Stout by Bold Republic Brewing Company, Temple, Texas. Silver goes to Overnight Oats, Wild Barley Kitchen and Brewery. True Tears of Joy. To the Hot Stove, Texas Leader Brewing Company, Missouri City, Texas. UK Styles with 38 entries, and the bronze goes to a beer simply named Amber Ale, St. Arnold's Brewing Company. And the silver goes to Golden Eagle, Phantom Warrior Brewing Company, Killeen, Texas. San Antonio. Yeah. goes to Electric Candlelight, Good Line Brewer Company, Lubbock, Texas. ETX Brewing Company, Tyler, Texas. Okay. The goal goes to Sky Screamer, Eureka Heights Brewing Company, Houston, Loggers, 37 entries. The bronze goes to Batch Pills, Batch, Austin, Texas. Demonstration Hills Pecan Brewing Company, Johnson City. And the gold goes to Dos de Greca, the Brewatorium, Brewery, and Kitchen, Austin, Texas. Alstatt Brewing Company, Craftbeer, Texas! Kolsch, Central District Brewing, Austin, Texas.
Company.
The silver goes to Allstadt Light, Allstadt Brewing Company, in Pittsburgh, Texas. Icy Boy! The American International Pilsner category, sponsored by BSG, delivering the finest, highest quality, both beer and beverage brewing supplies at competitive prices. BSG is the top brewing supply company choice for brewers everywhere. And I say that from experience. All right. So, category two, American and International Pilsners, 40 entries. And the bronze goes to Patek Pills, Pontecetta Brewing Company, Amarillo, Texas. And the silver goes to Pike's Peak Pilsner, Walking Stick Brewing Company, Houston, Texas. And the gold. Pilsner Resolve. Equal Parts Brewing Company, Houston, Texas. Thank you. German Pilsners category is also sponsored by BSG, and he's already up here, which is wonderful. And who knows that great beers are made from select ingredients? Everybody knows that. BSG Craft Brewing is committed to being your partner and shares your passion for creating outstanding beers. German Pilsner, 35 entries. The bronze goes to Frau Now, Buxton Brewing Company, Nederland, Texas. Silver goes to Gold, Live Oak Brewing Company, Austin, Texas.
And just the fact that you're
you're all here this weekend, I think, is also a testament to the camaraderie and the community that make our industry so special. I know it could have been anybody up here, and it could be you next year, so thank you all so much for participating. And with that, I am going to welcome our Brewery of the Year sponsor to the stage this year. He's a like a Madonna type, you know, one-word name. You all know him, you all love him. So please help me welcoming Stubby from TBI Pro Brew Supply.
Thank you so much, and I just want to say one thing before I get into my stuff. If you guys have ever been an organizer of a competition, even if it would be a homebrew competition, it's a difficult thing. So I would give a big round of applause to all the guys that organized this event. I put it on. They did an amazing job, I think. One of the things that I think is pretty amazing is I now get to travel all over the world. And one of the things that is really amazing to me, and I get to go to different guilds in different states, and there's nothing like home, man. You guys are awesome. I never see so much camaraderie and so much friendship between brewers. It's an amazing thing to say. And I just want to tell you guys thank you so much for my humble beginnings as a homebrew store in 2011. We now have warehouses in not only Texas, but in Chicago, Illinois, and we continue to grow. So thank you guys for believing in us. And man, to our customers, you guys made us look really damn good tonight. So congratulations.
Show here. As you all probably know, because you all read the competition rule guide rigorously, I'm sure. Our whole competition is judged blind, of course, and the Brewery of the Year award winners are based on medal totals throughout the evening, so bronze being 1 point, silver being 2, and gold being 3 points. Every year, we, after registration closes, we take a look at all the entries. Everyone had to submit their barrelage when they registered for the competition, and we try to divide it into two similarly competitive groups based on kind of that midpoint for barrelage, right? Because we know, you know, our average member is under 1,000 barrels of, you know, small and a large brewery of the year doesn't quite work. So try for two equally competitive groups based on size. And so with that, I'm going to let Stubby do the honors of announcing our Brewery of the Year for the under 600 barrel category.
So, I know these guys really well. They started out as a home brewers in my own personal homebrew club. So, the winner of this year's Brewer of the Year is Maple Branch Craft Brewing. Houston, Texas, True Anomaly Brewing. Yeah.
round of applause for our sponsors, our DJ, our brewers, our judges, our Texas Craft Beer community. Thank you all for spending your weekend with us. Thank you for attending these awards. Thank you for supporting your Texas Craft Brewers Guild. Please be safe as you're out there imbibing tonight. Get home safe, and let's brew and sell a bunch of beer, okay? Yeah.